hi there. Welcome to Markets Tomorrow right here on ED9, the Mumbai Centre. I'm Tanvi Gill. It was a decent session in the markets. We closed above 91.50, which was encouraging. It's been a good series. We closed out the March series, the last one for FY17 today. And essentially, it was on a high note. There was a 2% rally for the month of March for the benchmark indices, for the broader markets even more so, particularly for the Bank Nifty, which was in excess of 3.5%. We'll wrap up the top stories from the markets desk and then delve a bit more into how to approach the new trading day as also the new series come April. And that's really our top headline. Volatile expiry session ended on a positive note as investors rolled over their positions into the next series, and key ended at a new closing high of 9173, led by buying in realty and banks. Kotak Bank received board approval for its mega fundraising plan. The private sector lender will raise as much as 5,300 crores via issuance of over 6 crore shares. Funds to be raised via a combination of QIP, FPO and rights issue. Bank plans to acquire stressed assets as to pursue consolidation in the banking sector. Jet and SpiceJet were flying high in the session today. ET now learns that the Modi government is looking to open up the skies to foreign carriers. Sources suggest that the Civil Aviation Ministry as well as the aviation regulator DGCA has given in-principle approval to allow foreign carriers to 100% own, operate and control airlines in India. That's an ET now exclusive. And no reprieve was seen for liquor companies as the Supreme Court refused to revoke the ban on alcohol near national highways. Supreme Court placed public health over the Excise Act. Investors rushed in to buy Navneet Education on Motilal Oswal's positive note. A brokerage firm stated the syllabus overall as well as just the approach towards business is likely to boost sales in the future. Motilal guided for 22% revenue compounded annual growth rate over FY17 to FY19 for Navneet Education over the next 2 years. 22% is the kind of top line growth the company can witness. We'll make sense of the markets as we always do with voices lined up on the show. Sumit Nagar of Malabar Investments talks about his investment philosophy. We have Rajiv Thakkar, CIO of PPFAS Mutual Funds, also highlighting his investment views. Sameer Jawan of Angel Broking will be joining us with his technical perspective to help viewers approach trade tomorrow. And Ajay Vagao will give us his fundamental view on the markets as always. The question that we are asking and essentially starting off the discussion with is the Nifty ending the March series on a high? What lies ahead for the markets? What lies ahead in the new series, that is, and the new financial year? Good evening to both of you. Samita, I'll start off with you first. Closing at a high, where do we go from here?
Good evening. Yes, the Nifty has managed to close this derivative series on a high. It has closed tad below 9200, which is an encouraging sign. If you look at the price action since last 3 weeks, Nifty has been consolidating post the gap up opening that we saw post the UP election assembly results. And now we see consolidation in a broad range, wherein the range would be 9200, 9220 on the higher side, which acted as a steep hurdle for this series. And on the lower side, we saw buying emerging at lower levels. 9,000, 9,020 has been acting as a very strong support. Going by the slightly broader degree chart, if we consider the weekly and monthly chart, they are still quite positive, and we expect, you know, Nifty to surpass this hurdle of 9,200, 9,020 quite soon. Any dip, any consolidation within this range would be a good buying opportunity, as we expect, you know, Nifty to surpass this hurdle and move towards the next important levels of 9,400, 9,500 quite soon. So this would be a view that we have for at least next 2 to 3 weeks. Any dip would be a buying opportunity, and now the chart structure remains quite strong as long as Nifty manages to hold on this important support level of 9,8950 on a closing basis.
Ajay, good evening. Thanks very much for joining in as well. Your own view, because you know, come April, it's going to be profiling the markets with expectation of earnings revival in this year. And so, what is your estimate on that?
Yeah, Tanvir, I think fundamentally there is a big boost to the market three ways. One, global, a lot of global factors have got digested. we have French elections coming up, but you know, to see global markets going up yesterday on the day that the Brexit was actually triggered. So markets are shrugging off a lot of the news flows, and they're in a bull run. So I would say this is the time not to keep worrying that where are valuations headed, or is there a correction around the horizon. This is the time to systematically keep investing and picking up stocks of choice. I think the second big thesis that's come out is buy on dips has worked, sell on rallies has really not worked. Shorts have got squeezed out for the last 3 months, much more this month as well, and there's very little you know, fervor left in the bears. Now we have seen a lot of issues coming up, like Trump healthcare failure, and markets have just shrugged off and moved on. And third big thing is the flows have reversed after a long time for India. India is sitting on a very sweet spot, both in debt and in equity. We are seeing flows really coming in very sharply. The rupee strengthening, that's adding to our dollar returns and making the market even more attractive for foreign investors. The domestic money is very much there. The SIPs are contributing 5,000 crores plus. So tomorrow I anticipate a strong ending. The DIIs will dress up the index for the NAV management that happens. We saw that in the last half an hour on Bank Nifty, where particular counters were really managed and the index was taken up. I think tomorrow we'll see accelerated DII participation. But looking ahead, government is very strong, looks like a 7-year run for the national government, more or less the markets are factoring in. I expect a lot of liberalization on FDI. We are already seeing the rumors on the aviation space. I think a lot more areas will get freed up. So you're going to see FPI money coming in equities, in debt, as well as FDI. Domestic flows are strong. Domestic economy is recovering. In terms of earnings, I think more or less the market has discounted a tepid quarter. So come April 13th, when the earnings season starts, it starts with pretty low expectations. And so any positive surprise takes the market very high. While, you know, if the numbers come in very tepid, that's already discounted in. So I would say, you know, time to invest and time to hold on, buy on every dips.
Yes, indeed. I also want your perspective on what's really happening in the banking space. The big story of the day, Kotak Mahindra Bank doesn't rule out potential deal for a government stake in Axis Bank. Speaking exclusively to ET Now, the bank's top brass, top management says that the company will evaluate the offer as and when the government presents an opportunity. They did not clarify on many of the rumors, but pretty much laid out that they are looking at deploying the funds that they've raised for some meaningful increase in earnings, either through investments in bad loans or through strategic acquisitions.
Well, I think the basic requirement stems from RBI's communication towards the dilution of promoter stake. We have a initial dilution requirement to, if you recall, 30% by end of June. And we have a communication from the promoter that there is a partial dilution which the promoter has already done, and we need to, you know, progress forward. While you know, assessing that dilution requirement, we've also been looking at what all can these funds really be used for. And we have a reasonable array of end uses which are possible going forward. And I think the first one really is the fact that we will continue to be consolidators in the financial services space. So whether it is banking, it is other aspects of financial services, broking, maybe NBFC businesses, whatever it is. So that will require, you know, equity going forward.
Mr. Gupta, assuming that you are not able to find any suitable inorganic opportunity, I am using my words rather carefully, Do you think this current capital requirement, whenever you conduct it, that will be enough for next 2.5 to 3 years?
Again, it is not about only an inorganic opportunity, okay? Yeah, that is, yes, one of the potential uses. It could be one or more of these multiple things which we mentioned about. It's difficult to see which one would be first, which would be second, which would be there at all. But among these 3-4 key ones, I think we believe there is a fair requirement over the next 1 year for this capital.
Mr. Bhatt, Mr. Kotak certainly said cat amongst the pigeon when he mentioned that if the Sooty stake in Axis Bank is on the board, we would be open to buying it. What was he trying to indicate? You know, as members of press, we love to read in between lines. Should I read in between lines here?
We will evaluate every opportunity which comes in. So, as and when it is there, we will evaluate at that time.
But would you be interested in acquiring, stake or minority stake in other bank?
We will evaluate that. I mean, I'm not saying which we are in there or not there. We will have to take it when it comes.
Even that's a decision which the board has to take as and when that opportunity arises.
As and when the opportunity arises, saying that yes, it is an opportunity, and that they will evaluate time permitting in due course. Poonam joins us for a quick roundup of what the market is making of this news story. At 865, is the market upbeat about Kotak Bank's potential of going higher from here, given that it trades at 5 times price to book, so already is an expensive stock? Poonam?
That's right. In fact, Kotak Bank management did mention that they would be issuing close to 6.2 crore worth of shares, and that would in fact lead to a capital raising of somewhere around 5,300 crore. It would lead to a capital dilution of somewhere around 3.3%, and it would also lead to the capital adequacy ratio in fact increasing to as much as 20% odd. And do note that rough calculation does suggest that the addition to the FY18 consolidated book value would be somewhere around 30 odd rupees per share. Having said that, the management also did not mention the exact timeline of the capital raising, but it could be possible even before the June quarter, as the promoters have to bring down their stake further to nearly around 30% by June 30th. Not just that, management also mentioned that they're open to evaluate inorganic growth opportunities, and they're seeing a lot of opportunities in the entire stressed asset resolution space, and they're also open to participate as a bad bank in this space. They also stated that they will evaluate its Sooty stake in Axis Bank if and when the opportunity arises. So they're not really ruling out that that possibility at all, and they're also pretty much open to inorganic growth opportunities. So even that part is not ruled out. But a bad bank is also something that interests in, and probably we should be watching out on this entire stress assets and bad bank space. Maybe this is something in the near term. Probably we would see more announcement on this front from Kotak Bank on this matter. But as of now, capital raising of nearly over 5,300 crore is what Kotak Bank has suggested.
Thanks, Poonam, for that. We'll take a very short break, delve a bit more into opportunities in the banking space when we come back. But as we take that break, hear out Sumit Nagar speak exclusively to Chief Editor Markets Nikunj Dalmia at ET Now and talk about his investment philosophy.
Every company that we look to invest, we look for what is unique about them, right? And so in some ways, as an investor, we have to behave the same way. That what is it that we are thinking, or what is it that we see in an investment that other people don't see?
Can you give me an example?
Right. And so the example could be, I think you've talked before about Avanti Feeds, right? You know, it's a company that a lot of people have had concerns about, that, oh, there is fear about what can happen because of disease, and the volumes can just plummet. People think the market can go down, market share can go down, but without really sort of digging deeper into understanding that, right? And so if you do a lot of work and try to understand that what happened in Thailand was set of specific issues to that country, those kind of risks are very, very difficult to replicate themselves in India. You have a company here which is very strong. You know, they have two players which combined have 80% plus market share, which means that there is something specialized about what they do.
Are you happy to own iShares for next 5 years?
we're happy to own iShares for the next 5 years. You know, unless if, you know, if the valuation really goes to excessive level, which we don't think currently it's there. But if it does, then yeah, we will look at trimming or exiting, but not as of now.
The challenge for iShares is that as of now, they are riding just one platform. That's Royal Enfield. And that could be dangerous.
They've done a great job in terms of keeping that aspirational value of the brand, right? At least in India, I think it's very, very true. And I think they've also been one of the very few brands that have been able to transcend itself, you know, across generations, right? So you today, if you look at the average people who are buying, it's in the 20s, right? And so these are sort of new people that are bringing into the fold, right? And even today, the waiting period is there, right? So I think, you know, they've done a great job in terms of being able to do that. And that's just one leg. You know, the second leg is in terms of them, you know, taking this brand and this experience outside the country. And they've just started that. They just started seeding the markets. But I think it's a great optionality, right, for them, that if they get it right, there is, you know, market which is potentially 2x, 3x, 5x the size of the market that they're currently addressing.
Welcome back. Let's get in some more stories for our viewers that can make them research and think about potential investment opportunities in the market. The Modi government is looking at opening up the skies to foreign carriers in a setback for domestic airlines. ED Now exclusively learns from sources that the Civil Aviation Ministry as well as the aviation regulator, which is DGCA, have given in principle approval to allow foreign carriers to 100% own, operate and control airlines in India. Nandara Rai gets us this exclusive. Nandara?
I've been hearing about this government talking about liberalizing FDI. Is aviation sector going to be one of them? It certainly seems so. So now you have a situation where the DIPP as well as the aviation ministry, that's a nodal ministry, and the aviation regulator DGCA giving an in-principle approval for opening up the skies to foreign airlines, allowing 100% FDI, and also for allowing these foreign carriers to fully control and own all of the operations in India, including the aircraft. This is something the domestic carriers have very vociferously been speaking against ever since Qatar Airways talked about wanting to come to India with its own 100% owned airline. So what I do understand is the draft proposal has been prepared to this front. It has been sent to the Home Ministry. All of this is subject to security clearance. So Home Ministry is certainly going to play a very crucial role if India is going to open up the skies. So you have to watch out to see what the Rajnath Singh-led ministry has to say as far as this matter goes. And what I find very fascinating about this entire story is that the DIPP last year in its consolidated FDI policy had talked about allowing 100% FDI, allowing 100% control with the foreign carrier. However, we've seen all of this actually come back to the limelight only when Qatar Airways, looking at that last year's FDI policy, says, "Hey, I want to start an airline here," and that's when the domestic companies start rejecting.
Thanks, Nandara, for getting us that important story. This is, of course, about the aviation sector, which has been drawing a lot of interest from investors, and there's been a rally in those stocks, and we'll talk about that. But I also particularly want to talk about the stock of the day, Navneet Education. Motilal Oswal's new note on the company initiating a buy and putting out a target has made the market sit up and take notice. Karunya joins us to take us through the story. Karunya?
Well, the stock of the day is Navneet Education, which hit record highs during the day and closed with gains of about 9% after Motilal Oswal initiated buy rating on the stock with a target price of 210 rupees. If you look at the company, it's primarily into the business of publishing stationery products and digital education. And it dominates the market when it comes to supplementary education material. So basically, Motilal Oswal believes that the company will be a key beneficiary of demand of new raw material following syllabus overhaul. And another big positive for the company has been the recent acquisition of Britannica India's curriculum business for about 88 crore rupees, which it believes would be synergic to its CBSE curriculum business. Also note that the company's rival, which is S Chand, has also filed has also recently got a nod from SEBI to launch its IPO. So it could basically be rallying in trade because of a rub-off and a, you know, sentimental sort of an effect. And lastly, Motilal expects a 22% revenue CAGR and a PAT of 26% CAGR over FY17 to FY19.
Thanks, Karuna, for that. Ajay, I want to ask you about Navneet Education, but I will ask you about how you're seeing two pockets of interest, PSU banks, on the expectation that Mr. Kotak highlighted, that the cycle could be turning for bad loans if the economy per se is expected to see a recovery. And so that's why there could be additional profitability coming in from some of these bad loans, old bad loans turning good. So that's an opportunity for PSU banks. It's an opportunity for financing companies and also for ARCs who might be looking at buying these bad loans at the current levels. That's one. And secondly, if you could talk about aviation as well, because that's another badgered sector which is coming back on the back on the premise that there could be more opportunity with foreign players coming into the market.
Yeah, firstly on banking, I think first off, please invest in private sector banks and housing finance companies. Those will be the top performing sector, in my view, for the next few years. So first, you should load up on that. PSU banks is a good turnaround story. It has done well in the last 1 year, but on a five-year basis, you've hardly made any return. So there are enough thorns as well embedded. You have to be careful. I would say the safer bet would be stick with the top 3-4 PSU banks. That could be a more safer bet. Third, coming to aviation, it's a good story in a very strong growth market like India. If you allow more investments to come in, there will be market expansion, infrastructure growth will come in, and regional connectivity, as well as some impact coming through with lower taxes also on ATF by some states. So overall looking good based on the emerging flying class in India. So aviation could be owned as well.
Thanks, Ajay, for that. Sameet, come to you on strategies that will help our viewers tomorrow.
Since we are quite a bit on the market, we would maintain our optimistic view on individual stocks as well. Our first buy would be on Bajaj Auto. However, this particular stock has underperformed in last 2 weeks. But if we go by the broader degree charts, 2800 seems to be a very strong support. We had already witnessed a good price volume breakout 3 weeks back. So this particular stock, due to recent corrective move, has retested those breakout levels. So this becomes a low risk buy at 2800. One can buy with a stop loss somewhere around 2748 and keep a target of 3030 over the next few days. Our second buy would be on Yes Bank. Clearly, it has been outperforming stock within the private banking space, and it has almost closed at its all-time high. So we would expect this, you know, upward momentum to continue over the next few sessions. Our target would be somewhere around 1600-1620, which would be 4-5% from current level, and one can buy with keeping a stop loss somewhere around 1510.
Okay, gentlemen, we leave it at that. Thanks very much, Ajay, as well as Sameet, for joining us with your perspective on the markets and your insights, as always. We wrap up the show and leave our viewers with another opinion from Rajiv Thakkar this time, CIO of PPFAS Mutual Fund, his outlook on the market.
Markets can push forward on two factors, either earnings grow or people put a higher multiple on the earnings that are there or expected to come in. I think multiple growth, most people would agree, is close to where it can be. There's not much room left to go further. And in fact, some would argue for a multiple contraction. So the only thing that can take markets forward is growth in earnings. I'm not very hopeful in terms of the April-May numbers, which will be there for March ending, being significantly better than what people are expecting. I think more frenzy is in domestics rather than in overseas stocks. More frenzy would be in our small and mid-cap space.